Let's just take a look here. So first off, I have my iPad connected via USB cable directly into my MacBook. And as you can see up on my MacBook, I'm running the midimux server. And I'm gonna go ahead here and go to midimux. And we'll set up a new virtual MIDI port. And we'll call that dunk test, UNCTEST. And we'll go ahead and enter that. And now there's that new virtual MIDI port. And then we're gonna go over here and start GeoShred. And I'm gonna go under Menu, MIDI, and I'm choosing the MPE channel mode MIDI preset. You can edit that if you want to, but it should be set up pretty well for MPE. And I'm gonna look under the DIN connector, and I'm gonna see that I do see the two midimux in and out virtual ports. And then down here on the bottom, can see you can switch between MIDI in and MIDI out. By default, GeoShred has MIDI in because most of our users want to control GeoShred from a MIDI controller, but you want to use GeoShred as a sort of a virtual instrument, so you can select MIDI out. I will show you that there's a shortcut here. If you go under Settings and you go Enable MIDI IO button, it creates this little button on the bottom where you can switch between MIDI in and MIDI out. And so let's take this to the next step. We'll slide that over, look at the MIDI monitor, and let's look at the sources, and we'll see that you can see the two midimux sources, which is dunk test as well as GeoShred, and I'm going to play some notes on GeoShred. So we can see that they're coming in just fine through the MIDI monitor. Let's take it to the next step, and let's start Logic Pro. We'll move this out of the way. And I'm going to create a new project, and I'm going to make an empty project, and I'm going to make this an external MIDI project, and for output, I'm going to select dunk test, all MIDI channels, so that it can play back into GeoShred. I'm going to go ahead and create that, and that's great. Now let's put this here so that we can see both things at the same time. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit record up here. And we'll just record a little bit of MIDI coming from GeoShred. That looks great. It looks like it's recording just fine. I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording. I'm going to rewind the recording. I'm going to switch the MIDI direction to MIDI in. And we'll go ahead and play it back. You can see it flies the expression pad.